There is a purpose. There is a definite purpose. Because we take all the examples from the dream and relate it to the waking dream, the dream dream.
Yes.
So,
it is like a mini model.
Yeah, of what it
like. Yeah, yeah, what this world is. So if we can relate to that, then you will get a lot of wisdom from it. Okay. Yaena veti hantaram.
Yaena veti hantaram.
Yaschenam manyate hatam.
Yaschenam manyate hatam.
Ubhauto na vijanito.
Ubhauto na vijanito.
Nayam hanti na hanyate.
Nayam hanti na hanyate.
Yaha is he who, enam is this self, veti knows, hantaram, slayer. Yaha, he who, cha and. Enam is again this, manyate means thinks, hatam means slain, ubhav, both, tau, those. Na is not, vijani taha. No, na means not. Ayam, this, hanti, slays. Na, not. Hanyate to slay. Okay. Anilji, up anyone?
He who takes the self to be the slayer and he who thinks he is slain, neither of them knows. He slays not, nor is he slain.
So now with that example that I gave you, from that example you think about it.
Basically, what I am understanding is, he is saying, self is, nothing is happening to the self.
Correct.
Neither is self killing, nor it is killed. So right. Self is...
Yes, yeah, so you got it. That's exactly what he's trying to say. So, and also, he's saying that the person who is thinking that, oh, I'm dying, and the person who is killing the other person, neither of them knows. Yeah.
Know the truth, yeah.
Yeah, and then that's what he's saying.
It is a Hindu tradition that the children of Aryavrata, though they may appreciate intellectualism, do not accept any theory as a spiritual or philosophical idea, unless the new theory or restatement has been exhaustively proved to be fully supported by the existing immortal scriptures, the Upanishads. This idea was so strictly followed in the past that even Lord Krishna, considered by the Hindus as the greatest manifestation of the reality that ever came upon the earth as an incarnation, had to substantiate his declarations with quotations from Upanishads. Herein we have the meaning of a well-noted mantra, Kathopanishad, summarized.
So now, remember at one time, Meenaji, you had brought that point that why did they say Krishna had to say ki wise people say that? Here
right,
is the
right.
answer. That in those days, just because kisi ne bol diya, Krishna kyo na ho wo, they are not going to believe him until it is supported by the Shastra. Because it's just something like a scientific theory.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't believe until it has been proven. Because we have faith in the system,
yes.
That it has been proven, by, and then verified by 100 other people, then you declare it. Today I saw in this meditation, that's why it is like that. No. I saw this and they are also seeing it. So that's why.
And you know, I would think a form, when I see a form, it's hard to believe in that. A form is saying that. You know, an individual. It comes out as an individual is saying that. Therefore, though he was the Lord himself, Krishna, he had to say that this is taken from such and such. You know, I mean, I look at it that way also.
It's a good way to look at it too. And there is another...
Because the other doesn't know how much, you know, like Arjuna didn't know all the depth of Lord Krishna till he went through everything.
Yeah, and that's why Krishna Bhagavan right now has to tell that. Also, we discussed that. He doesn't know his complete divinity yet.
Yes.
So he has to verify it with the Shastras.
Shastras.
And then the other point I was trying to make is that sometimes if you just believe in one person's word, it can be changed, it can be messed around with, and fanaticism comes in, people take it wrong. But five other people come, that's not what this guy is saying. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And even I have experiences, this is how it is, but that's how Hinduism is. Hinduism is like, continuously people experience the same thing and verify, whereas some of the other religions, when there is only like one person saying it, it's somewhat dangerous.
It's reinforced by the next person.
Exactly. You know, it's like somebody said, ki, who started Hinduism? Kisi ko pooch, Swami ji ko poocha kisi ne. To unhone example se jawab diya. Unhone, unhone bola, who's the author of science? What a great answer. There's not one person. There is a law that pervades this universe, and then you are discovering the law. That's what Hinduism is. They're trying to find the truth. You know? I thought that was such a brilliant answer.
Yeah.
You know?
The self being immutable is neither slain nor can it be the slayer. Those who think that they have been slain when the body is slain, and those who feel that they are the slayers, are both ignorant of the real nature of the self, and hence they simply prattle meaningless assertions. That which is killed is the perishable body, and the delusory arrogation, I am slain, belongs to the ego center. The self is that which is beyond the body and the ego. Since the pure consciousness is the illuminator of both, the body and the ego. In short, being immutable, the self can neither be the agent nor the object of the action of slaying.
See, the another important thing he said, this pure consciousness is the illuminator of both these factors, the body and the ego. So one is this, shell, body is like a shell or a house or something, and the indweller is the jiva, the ego, dono se bhi upar hai. Because when we say, you know, jiva is like a bundle of vasanas and mind and intellect all put together that travels
with it, yeah,
in the different lives. So he's saying that atma is beyond these both of them.
So what is pure consciousness?
So pure consciousness is that Brahman, that substratum, the truth, the self, jo bhi tum bolna chahe, naam, om, you know. So he is pointing us to that, jisme koi farak nahi hota hai.
Right.
Doesn't change, but you need that self for the world to go on.
Mm.
You know, I should bring the BMI chart. It'll be so, because Om, where Om is, where the intellect is, where the ego resides, it would be so much clearer. Because
so we can do it next week. We can
I'll bring that chart,
yeah.
BMI chart.
Oh,
or they even takes a minute to draw. And I think it is in that book also, is there?
That
book is there.
Okay, in the first, okay.
Yeah, yeah. I can work on it and we can do it at home.
I can just bring it next time.
Because Swamiji explains in a certain way that it's easier to understand the Atma.
As you were saying, the picture comes right away in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's.
But at this stage, just remember that there are two different aspects. One is the Atma, one is the body in this world that is constantly changing, and this stays the same. If we get that, then it will help us to go further Swamiji was saying that we may not understand everything right now, because now the question will come, who does the action, and all that is coming in chapter 3. You know, who acts is the body, it's a nature, it's the three gunas, and all that is going to come, you know. And then why do we need to act? Why did he tell him if self is immutable? Because the way the conditioning is right now, we cannot come out of it until we purify our mind. How to purify our mind? By doing the karma yoga. Karma yoga means doing in such a mode that we don't get more impression. So I'm just kind of summarizing that why we have to do what we have to do. Well, because intellectually we might say, I understand, but our impressions are still there in our mind.
One more thing later on it comes that made a good impression on me is that how you change your clothes for different occasions. You are going for the interview, you are wearing a suit and a tie, you are going to play tennis, you're not going to play it in a suit and a tie.
So nicely explained, right?
So that's why you change your
body. And you get the appropriate body for that particular life. Because usko aisa kyun mila, kyun mila nahi, uske liye wahi theek tha.
You're finished?
Yeah,
just one more line.
Okay.
How is this self immutable? This is answered in the next verse.
Okay. Here they're saying even the, they're saying in the soul, but even they're saying matter also is, you know, it's not destroyed at all. Everything remains the same space, just like the ocean water remains the same. Same thing also, whether it's the spirit or the matter. They all get condensed into nature.
So you know, when we were doing like different philosophies,
nothing,
so one of the Sankhya philosophy believes eternity of both, this, like you were saying, matter. But science also says, no, matter to energy, energy to matter.
Yeah.
True or
so
not?
So it's really one then.
Yeah.
It's
just the, like the way it is explained in Bhagavad Gita in chapter 7 is going to come, my higher and my lower nature. My higher nature is immutable and all is that Atma. Lower nature is Prakriti. But Prakriti uske adheen hai. Tabhi usko Mayapati bhi bolte hai. Uske bina, it's like waves cannot function without the ocean.
Yeah.
It's tied with it. That's, so there are several ways to understand. But whatever you're saying is true even from the scientific perspective. But the nature of the elements is it constantly changes. किसी ने बोला कि हमारे बॉडी में ना कितने होते हैं पता नहीं, इट्स सम क्रेजी नंबर ऑफ सेल्स, यू आर इन
बिलियंस ऑफ सेल्स,
बिलियंस एंड बिलियंस, राइट? सो जब हम, हमारी डेथ होती है ना बॉडी की, तो सब डिसइंटीग्रेट होके वो एलिमेंट्स में मिल जाते हैं, राइट? फिर भी नई बॉडी मिलती है, तो इसे इफ यू रियली थिंक अबाउट इट, अमंग योर बिलियंस ऑफ सेल्स, उसमें सेंट की भी सेल होगी तुम्हारे और किसी सिनर की भी हम लोग सोचते हैं, इट्स जस्ट रिसाइकलिंग हो रहा है मटेरियल,
या इफ यू एवर मेड कंपोज, यू नो इट्स सो अमेजिंग, यू नो एवरीथिंग बिकम्स मड,
यस, बट
वी डिसअपीयर,
वी डिसअपीयर, बट वेयर आर वी कमिंग फ्रॉम, फूड हम लोग खाते हैं, साइंटिफिकली इट्स अ कंप्लीट रिसाइकलिंग गोइंग ऑन कॉन्स्टेंटली. And then that one show that I told you about, Strange Rock, so they are observing the earth from above, and now because of the photography, usko kya bolte hai, jisme fast forward photography karte hai wo log, like ek fool khilta hua dikhate hai, right?
Yeah.
Aisa kuch karte hai. So unhone itni sari pictures leke na, different season ka kiya fast mein. So it looks like earth is breathing. It looks so amazing. And because it's like a living planet.
Yeah.
Constantly, thousands of activities are going on here. You know?
Wherever there's mud, there's something will grow.
Yes.
And
then another,
the temperature can support
it. I watch, because of my son, I watch all these crazy shows, but they're so great. Like, they were saying ki, you know, they were trying to find ki bhai life can survive under what conditions. So they, ye pata nahi ye log kitne crazy hain. They went in the North Pole, और ice wise को एकदम dig wig करके नीचे गए वो लोग. I mean so daring. I mean हम लोग तो वहाँ भी नहीं जाएंगे. ये लोग अंदर घुस गए और नीचे जाके देखा तो there was some form of life form still surviving, not a very advanced one like bacterium type. And they said it doesn't get any sun. For life to survive, you need sunlight. So they said वहाँ कैसे पहुँच गई sunlight? So then they did the testing. तो 1% का भी 100th हिस्सा का लाइट जाती है वहाँ.
अच्छा.
हाँ. एंड लाइफ कैन सर्वाइव इन दैट. सो आई वाज थिंकिंग अबाउट दैट होम्योपैथी, हाउ दे से यू नो माइन्यूट इज थिंकिंग, सो इट्स ट्रू.
या
बट यू नो इट्स सो मिस्टीरियस दिस होल वर्ल्ड इज, यू नो. Okay, so let's see the time.
So this parallel about this thing they said about that when you see the movie, it's like electric shadows and you really don't kill each other. So we are also actually electronic bodies only.
Yeah.
So we are really not killing anybody.
True.
Just
yeah, that's a good example.
Yeah.
Kitna baja abhi?
11:45. One bara.
Achha. So do we do one more or should we go to Mandukya? Is it too heavy?
Mandukya.
Huh?
I think the next chapter is big for me, so I don't know, 20s.
Now he's going to talk about a little, like Swamiji was explaining, that he's going to talk about some positive aspect of what it is and what it is not, the Atma. That's
yeah, I think the 20 is a big chapter for me, I don't know for you all.
We can start and then if we can do another 15 minutes and then we can stop because that will give us something to think about. Okay, here is a different tune, so let me see if I can remember. Najayate mriyate vakata chit. Najayate mriyate vakata chit. Nayam bhutva bhavitavan bhuyaha.
Nayam bhutva bhavitavan bhuyaha.
Ajo nitya shashvato yam purana.
Ajo nitya shashvato yam purana.
Nahanyate hanyamani sharire.
Nahanyate hanyate mani sharire.
Kwan, aap padhna chahenge?
Main to rehne do.
Shireen, you can read that. Or let me do the Sanskrit. Yeah. Na is not. Jayate is born, mriyate dies, va is or, kadachit at any time, na is not, ayam is this, bhutva having been, bhavita will be, va or, na is not, bhuyaha is more, ajaha means unborn, nityaha is eternal, shashvata is changeless, ayam is this, puranaha is ancient. This Purana word is very interesting in Sanskrit language. The when they break the words is Purana api nava, meaning Purana hote bhi bhi naya hai. Just like sunrise we see. It is so ancient, 5 billion years, whatever old, but it looks so fresh and new. That's what it means. Na is not. Hanyate is killed. Hanyamane being killed. Sharire is in body.
He is not born, nor does he ever die after having been. He again ceases not to be. Unborn, eternal, changeless, and ancient. He is not killed when the body is killed.
So here, Krishna Bhagavan is just hammering more about the nature of Atma so that he just remembers this, and we have to remember it. Okay.
This stanza labors to deny in the self all the symptoms of mutability that are recognized and experienced by the body. The body is prone to different changes, and these modifications are the sources of all sorrows in every embodiment. These six changes are common to all, and they may be enumerated as birth, existence, growth, decay, disease, and death. These changes are the common womb of all pains in the mortal's life. All these are denied in the self in the stanza to prove the immutability of the self. Unlike the physical body, the self is not born. It being the eternal factor that exists at all times. The waves are born and they die away, but the ocean is not born with the waves, nor does it die when the waves disappear. Since there is no birth, there is no death, things that have a beginning alone can end. The rising waves alone can mourn their dying conditions. Again, it is explained that like the birth of a child who was not in existence before and who has come to exist after the birth, the Atma is not something that has come to be born due to or because of the body. Thus, the self is unborn, eternal, birthless and deathless.
Ajaha and Nitya.
Ajaha and Nitya. Having thus stated the proposition that the self is neither an agent nor an object or the action of slaying, and having established by arguments the immutability of the self, Lord Krishna here concludes the proposition as follows.
Oh, so there's one paragraph, yeah. You want to read that? Upar Satya. By the term.
By the term unchangeable.
Yes.
Shashvata.
All other modifications, such as existence, growth, decay, and disease, are denied in the self. When the body is slain, the self is not slain. Just as when a wave is destroyed, the ocean is not destroyed. When a part is broken, the mud is not broken. The verse insists that self cannot be killed, which is an assertion which amounts to repetition, since it has already been said that it is deathless. Shankara therefore interprets the idea in it is not slain to it has no transformation. The self is not subject to any transformation or transmigration.
Transmigration is like a जो अपने क्या बोलते हैं पुनर्जन्म को बोलते हैं transmigration. So he's just telling you that now he's going a little more in detail because he's we know that when we see in the world, you know, people are born and then they grow and then the six things that he talks about are very important. That firstly, that's what happens to everybody: birth, existence, growth, decay, disease, and death. And he also said very profound thing that these are common wombs of all pain. Jitna bhi humko pain hai na, abhi if you think about it, Arjun's grief was for the same thing. You know, that his great grandfather, it was not even a grandfather. Usko ek din to marna hi tha na. You know, so he's like, oh my God, I can't live without him and things like that. And so that's what he's saying, that this is denied. And then your one line was not there in your book also. This word is also substantial and faithfully reproduction of the words of Yama in Kathopanishad. If anybody knows what Kathopanishad is, it's a conversation with Lord of Death and this little boy, Nachiketa. Right? So these are the words of Yama also, because Nachiketa wanted to know, I want to know that final thing, what it is, which doesn't change. Mm. You know? So that Yama also, this he has taken. That's why they said these two verses are taken from Kathopanishad. So my desire is after we finish, Mandukya will pick up Kathopanishad, because this Bhagavad Gita and Kathopanishad go very much together. Okay. So, and the other, whatever, you now you know why he's repeating, like changeless and eternal. Each one gives a little more deeper understanding of it. And if there is any doubt left in us about anything, you're just capping those doubts about, you know. So,
next time, do we go with 20th? Because she was saying, Sneha was saying that it's a big thing. And or you want to summarize next time?
Yeah, next time I'll summarize it.
Yeah, you can study and bring all the important points that Yogananda ji is saying. Mm. So we'll have another way of looking at it.
Looking
yes.
at the 20th itself.
Yeah, right. Because it's 20th is... It's very much like a meditative verse. Mm-hmm. You know, it's telling you the nature of Atma that's changeless. You know, there's Purana, ancient, not killed when the body's killed.
And sabse badi baat jo I'm getting out of that is when your life is going through different stages, that you don't let it bring you sorrow.
Correct.
Ki ab main budha ho raha hu, main bimar ho raha hu.
Aur mar raha hu, ye ho raha hu.
Because
वो तो होना ही होगा
होना ही होगा so just accepting it makes it so
gracefully accepting it and the saints and sages that's why we revere them so much because we see them unshaken by everything
yeah.
you know it's not that उन्होंने कुछ और कोई बड़ी बड़ी चीजें accomplish कर ली their mind is so much in peace and control that they emit that when we are with them
because I also know about a person who was so spiritual, he died of cancer, but he refused all cancer medication to relieve the pain. Because when people ask him, you know, are you uncomfortable? He said, I feel no pain.
Oh.
So he had totally...
Discipline.
He was so connected with
so
the
connected.
Higher.
Yeah.
So connected with the higher. I mean, you know, Ramana
Maharshi. Yeah, discipline tha na, that he didn't feel the pain. Like,
yeah, and you can bring
all,
yourself to
everything
that
is emotional only. They say even all diseases are all psychosomatic only, they say.
I mean, from the Ayurvedic perspective, they say that all the wrong actions, infiltrate in the body and that's why we get...
Wrong emotions, all the grudges
I don't do anything wrong, but what do you eat? What do you see? Do you hurt anybody? I mean, we'll have a long list of things we do wrong.
Yeah.
Even from the medical perspective, we do half of the things wrong. Whatever they tell you not to eat, that's what tastes the best to us.
Also, kisi ko... थोड़ा कट हो जाए तो इज स्क्रीमिंग लाइक हेल और किसी का हाथ भी कट जाए तो इज काम
दे हैव लाइक सो मच पेशेंस एंड कंट्रोल आई हैव सीन दैट मायसेल्फ एंड इन फैक्ट इन द बिगनिंग व्हेन आई हैड जस्ट जॉइंड चिन्मय मिशन इन ह्यूस्टन व्हेन आई वाज इन माय 30s सो वी यूज्ड टू लिव नियर द कैंसर सेंटर बिकॉज़ भारत वाज वर्किंग देयर सो सम टाइम यू नो सम पीपल हु वर द डिवोटीज दे वर पेशेंट सो दे टोल्ड मी टू टेक द खाना और समथिंग सो आई वेंट देयर And I was so shocked about how serene they were, just like you are saying. Because, you know, like they were literally going to be dying because their cancer was so advanced. And they were like totally, I'm fine. And they had all the nice books around them, yogi, this, that. And I went home and I said, my God, whatever they have, that's what I want to get. Because I said, if I was in that situation, I'd be screaming and shouting. I would warn all my family and I would say, oh, this, that. It really shook me up that there is something that these guys have.
Definitely.
Because this was a real practical demonstration in front of me.
Another example is Mother Teresa.
Yeah.
She will hug and take care of the
lepers. Yeah.
Leopards.
Exactly. Hum log to
dur ho jaye, dar jaye,
you know. Yeah, true.
Nothing ever touched her.
There's a new movie, The Sky is Pink. It's about a girl, like, actually she was destined to die right in the, within 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
Then how she, you know, she finally died at the age of 27.
Mm-hmm.
But the whole family consciously decided that they're going to, you know, be happy and she's going
right,
to
right.
Yeah.
That you'd celebrate her life,
yeah,
whatever
yeah.
it was.
Yeah.
So accept what has happened
yeah.
and move on.
Yes.
Yeah, just realizing this body is changing your clothes.
Mm.
Correct. And Swamiji was saying, yeah, little kids cry when you change their clothes. Yeah, they do cry, right?
Right.
But adults don't. So become adult in this. he gives this such a simple example.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
You know?
And here they say, God is immortal and we are the images of God. So that's why we are also immortal. Soul is the
right,
immortal.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think in Christianity also there's a sentence of God made man in his image.
In
yeah.
his own image.
So all the different religions say the same thing too. Okay. So, good. We can go to. This was a good,
wonderful,
good class. Bhadram Karni Vishnyam Deva. भद्रं पश्येमाशभिर्यचत्राः स्थिरैर्मङ्गैः सुष्ठुवागं स्वस्तनूभिः वृषेण देवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृतशवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्वपिताः स्वस्ति न स्ताक्षर्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः नारायणं तद्भुवं वशिष्ठं नारायणं तद्भुवं वशिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्द योगीन्द्र मथास्य शिष्यं गोविन्द योगीन्द्र मथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्य मथास्य पद्मपादं श्रीशङ्कराचार्य मथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यम् चहस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्त्रोटकं वार्तिककार्यमन्यान् तन्त्रोटकवार्तिककार्यमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरुन् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि अस्मद्गुरुन् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि.
Which chapter is that, should we mark?
Oh, you want to mark that?
Mm-hmm.
It is in the beginning of this chapter.
Fourth chapter
ke beginning mein hai, like after two pages.
Fourth chapter.
Beginning. This is a prarthana, and this is, as I have just to remind us what
fourth
it is.
Fourth chapter beginning.
It's telling you that this knowledge is coming from the highest. It's not concocted because it sounds so outlandish. To okay. people who, some people. Now we are kind of getting tuned to it. Imagine,
yes.
It is coming almost.
This one.
Yes. Oh my God, it
yeah.
was like
yeah.
so long. We started, this is how we started this class was through Mandukya only. And you know, people who join later, you can, someday when you have time, go and read the 12 mantras up, because there are only 12 mantras.
I was going to say, that's important, yeah.
So what we can do is, after we finish this, we
then
will just go through the 12
yeah.
mantras,
especially,
and it will open
one.
Up in our mind.
Especially
mm.
the seventh one, that
yeah.
is the depth, most
yeah.
depth in it.
Mm. True. So. Okay, so 60. Everybody, whoever has a book has it. Najeshu sarvadharmeshu.
Najeshu sarvadharmeshu.
शाश्वता शाश्वतामिधा
शाश्वता
शाश्वतामिधा यत्र वर्णान वर्तन्ते
यत्र वर्णान वर्तन्ते
विवेकस्तत्र नोच्यते
विवेकस्तत्र नोच्यते.
न इज कैनॉट बी इज सॉरी न इज कैनॉट बी अजेशु इज अनबोर्न ईगोज Sarva dharmeshu, in the case of any entity or egos, Shashvata is permanent. Ashashvata is impermanent. Amidha is indestructible.
Indescribable.
Indescribable. True. See how all the same things are coming here, right?
Yeah.
Shashvata is like permanent and, you know, everything is like. Yatra is where, Varnaha is word, na vartante, do not function, Vivekaha, discrimination, Tatra, there, with regard to any entity, na uchyate, cannot be said. So here, I was just thinking that here, he's using the dream example, and sometime in the beginning, it sounded so outlandish, but he's saying exactly the same thing Krishna Bhagwan is saying, he's just using the worldly example for us. So that we get it, that's all. Otherwise, he's saying the same thing.
Yeah.
Okay, Sushila, 60, the epithets.
What about you?
Oh, you can read it.
Once we accept the epithets,
read
of permanent,
the, yeah.